It's interesting hearing your own bio. Just shows you how amazing God has been to you. That's all that is. But good evening, everybody. Okay, let's do that again. Good evening, everybody. Let's act like this graduation here. Let me get some of that energy. Clap it up for yourselves this evening. Listen, I want to give you all two things about me. The very first thing is anytime I get the chance to share my gift and pour into people, I'm extremely grateful. But the first thing I do is give all glory and honor to God, because without God, nothing is possible. Amen? Amen. And then the second thing is, listen, I want y'all to know that we family. So in these next few minutes, I'm going to say some things to you all. And out of love and respect, I want you to give me some great energy. Can we do that just for a few moments? Awesome, because I didn't come here to play with y'all today. So I hope you are ready. I hope that you all are ready. To all the superintendents, the superintendent, the principals, the faculty and staff, first and foremost, thank you to each and every one of you all. I am a proud product of DPS myself, an Osborne graduate, so I know it's not easy for you all and the work that you do. So let's give it up for the staff that's helped us get here. To the parents, the mentors, the support system, as she said before, I understand some of the things that you all go through to make sure that each and every one of these young kings and queens got here. So let's clap it up for the parents and the mentors and the faculty and the staff. And lastly, to the graduates, it's truly an honor to be standing before you all today. I'm born and raised in 48205. I was told I'll never be anything. I was told I would never make it to the finish line. I was told to shut up my entire life, and now I get the opportunity to speak to thousands and millions of people all over the world. And the fact that you all have persevered through all the adversity that's been faced in front of you to be here today, it is nothing to take lightly. So let's clap it up for the graduates one more time, everybody. Now, they always ask me, why do you say your zip code is infamous, the 48205? Yeah, East Side, Red Zone. Now listen, in the last decade, 48205 has made it on the top 10 worst list of neighborhoods to live in the United States of America. They said children from that zip code were struggling in elementary, middle, and high school, less likely to receive a high school diploma, even more less likely to receive a college degree. By the age of 21, they would have anywhere between 1 to 3 children. And by the age of 25, they would have a criminal background or dead. Now I stand before you all at the age of 31, letting you know that I'm a proud product of 48205, and I'm not a statistic, amen? Now I'm not gonna run through the accolades because today is not about me, but I do wanna mention this. I went to Michigan State University for 7 long years. I was a senior, I was a super senior, and then I was an extended senior. And then my last year, I got an email saying, if you don't graduate this year, we're gonna kick you out ourselves. Now, why am I telling you all that? Because some of you all may be sitting here today thinking, in 4 years, I'm gonna go get me a degree. But that may not be God's plan for your life. Because on your journey of success, you're gonna encounter detours. You're gonna run into some frustration. You're gonna get told no. But I need you all to remember that rejection is God's protection for your direction. Amen. Now, graduates, listen to me. They say when you're younger, you look like your parents. Well, I say when you're older, you look like the decisions you made in life. So today is not just important because you all are walking across this stage today. Today is important because you all have made a decision that 33% of high schoolers all over the world would never get the opportunity to make. Today is also important because you're all gonna persevere through life and create platforms to be a blessing for other people. And the more you give and the more you bless people, the more God will give and bless you to you, all right? And I need you all to remember this. No matter where life takes you, whether it's to the peaks of success or to the lowest of the valleys, I need each and every one of you all to take God with you. Because I'm sure your parents, your support system, they all can attest that God has kept them on their journey, amen? Now, some of you all started, stopped, left, came back, then finished, but God kept you. Some of you all had more faith than you had financial assistance, but God kept you. And some of you all turned up more than you turned in assignments, but God still kept you. And some of you all are graduating with honors, while others are just honored to be graduating, but God still kept you. And when things go wrong, as they sometimes will, when the road you're trudging seems all uphill, remember that God will never take you to a place where he's not willing to protect you. Now, I know it's hard on y'all. The world has projected you to fail. Your day ones and some of your confidants stop believing in you. You look at the finish line and you with a whole new circle of friends. But remember that God gives his hardest battles to his toughest soldiers. And to my parents, I need you all to treat these young kings and queens like seeds. Because how do seeds grow? First, you have to plant them in the right soil. And it's very important for you to place them in the right atmosphere that's going to fertilize their thinking to build the roots of courage and confidence. Then seeds need water and sunlight. It's time for you all to pour into and shed light on their ideas, so not only are they confident in sharing their ideas with you, but they're confident enough to share their ideas with the entire world. Because when the windstorms of trials and tribulations, they're coming. But they won't break, nor will they bend, because they will be standing on the barks of commitment. And then you all will reap the bright fruit, blossoming from their trees of success due to the content of their character. And to my graduates, I'm going to give you all five pieces of advice before I sit down. Advice number one, give yourself grace. Give yourself grace. You have to go through life to get through life. Life is not easy, like tying your shoe. You can tie your shoes in the dark with a blindfold on because you've been doing it for so long. You're going to make mistakes. You're going to fail at some things in your life. But don't be so hard on yourself that you never forget God has given you another chance and another chance and another chance. So always give yourself grace, because some people counted you out. Little did you know, they just didn't know how to count, because you are here today. So always give yourself grace to keep moving forward. Piece of advice number two. Function comes before the title. Function comes before the title. You have to become before you become. You have to be the boss before you get the CEO title. You have to be the leader before you gain a leadership role. What am I saying to you all? You have to put in the work now before you get a platform to where the money is going to come, to where the success is going to come, to where the freedom is going to come. So as you are walking around, whether it's college, whether it's entrepreneurship, whatever it may be, do the work first and you will enjoy the freedom and everything that comes with it afterwards, okay? Piece of advice number three, make sure you execute more than you give excuses. Make sure you execute more than you give excuses, because the more you fall in love with your excuses, the more them excuses gonna fall in love with you. And in life, it's either you get it done or you talk about doing something you never did. And if you all are confused or have any doubts, just never forget this moment when you had some friends who graduated a few months ago and you had to go through school a couple more months. You had to take a couple more classes while you had some friends out having fun, partying, turning up, doing all the fun stuff kids like to do in the summer. But you were so committed to your execution and not the excuse. This is the sole reason why you are sitting in this seat today. So make sure you execute more than you give excuses. Piece of advice number four, the energy you give in this world will change your perspective of what you have on this world. I'm gonna say that again, the energy you give to the world will change your perspective of how you look at this world. Most people in the world, it's not the problem that's the issue. It's the energy that they're giving to the problem. And one thing I've learned in a great scripture in the Bible, greater is he that is within him than he is within the world. God is bigger than your situation. So be careful of the energy that you give a problem, a mistake, whether it's a breakup, whether it's a missed opportunity. There's more opportunities. There's more people who want to love on you. But if you walk around with positive energy, it will refuel you. And if you walk around with negative energy, it will drain you. And the last piece of advice I have for you, be impeccable with your word. You all are phenomenal. You all are worthy. Your life is valuable. Just do what you say you're going to do. Just do what you say you're going to do, and I can assure you everything in this life that you want will come to pass. In 2017, I was homeless for 8 months, and I was sitting in my car, and I was praying to God. I said, I'm ready to throw in the towel. He said, the problem is you're so worried about the big things in life. that you're not paying attention to the smaller things. And in the midst of being homeless, he birthed 1% better inside my spirit. Every single day that you wake up, ask yourself a simple question. How can I get at least 1% better today? Mentally, physically, spiritually, emotionally, 1% at a time. That's just 15 minutes out of your day. So if y'all gonna sit here and tell me y'all ain't got 15 minutes, I'm gonna tell you, you hustling backwards. Because if you sacrifice today, 1 year from now, you would have increased the efficiency in your daily operation by 365%. So graduates, that means you're gonna move on a different level. That means that you're gonna think on a different level. And more importantly, you're gonna win on a different level. Thank you all for having me. Congratulations again, graduates.
Great job.
Thank you.